What's up, Rhodes Scholars? It's your boy Baylor Rhodes, back with another episode. So like I promised, we're going to do a little series where I will speak on certain topics in the YouTube community, in life in general, probably even some political things. But while we're doing this series, I will be playing video games in the background, and we'll just have a casual conversation. But today, like I promised in the previous video, we will also be going to collect flamingos. I think that's the best topic for this situation, since we're going to be talking about two fellas in Miami. So, without further ado, let's get into it. And let's get on the road and get to business. Y'all haven't seen this one yet. This is what we call the Black Ranger, the Mega Sword, the Ninja Sword, the Frog. Right here. Oh, I just pulled somebody pulled up in front of me. Ooh. My bad. So basically in this one, man, we're just gonna go through and we're going to look for flamingos. But serious talk. Let's talk about Fresh and Fit. I've been wanting to make something just talking about them recently and what's been going on with the things that just been happening so far with them. And disclaimer, I don't dislike Fresh and Fit or nothing like that. It's just some things that just needs to be like that I would like to address on a certain topic. You know, one, first off, I watch Fresh and Fit religiously just to hear some of the things that they say, because it is knowledgeable to a certain extent. You know, if you live in that area, or you live in that big area like California or New York, where these things typically happen to men. And I do watch their Money Mondays, and not so much on Wednesdays. I only watch their shows on Wednesdays. Oh, where's this from? But this is right here. This is a very awkward flamingo right here. Fridays, I don't really watch their, whatever they do on Fridays, I don't really watch that one either, but I think that's credit. But for sure, Mondays I watch all the time. And also I watch their, there it is. Also I watch their, two, you know, their late night special. And over the past year, I kind of just been watching and just nodding my head and, you know, just thinking to myself, like, man, they do bring up some valid points. But lately, they've been kind of, I think they've been doing a lot of things, not because they're stupid, because obviously they're not dumb, but I feel like they've been doing, I don't want to say I feel, because that's not what I should be saying. I believe that that they've been doing certain things just to get a ticket. If you kind of understand what I'm saying. This is a disclaimer. I'm not saying any of this is true or anything like that. This is just me voicing what I have seen over the past year. You know, so we definitely have to start with. And I know I'm driving in a circle trying to find these flamingos. I'm really trying to find a way out. Oops. Ooh. So we have to start with the copyright strike thing. I honestly think that was... I honestly think that was really dumb on their part. You can't go around copyright striking people. Because people are criticizing you or saying negative things about you. I'm not even relevant yet on YouTube. I'm not even a big YouTuber yet. But would you guys help by subscribing? We can definitely get there together, Rose Scholars. But, dang, I do not want to go this way. I don't think I'll come. I need to find a flamingo in this city. You're going to get criticized, and people are going to talk about you in different lights and the things you do. And we all know that Fresh, we know that Fresh got this sugar mama from a sugar mama site, and he's, you know, he's never denied it. That he's on the sites and everything like that. So, I'm not criticizing him for that. But what I would criticize him for, like everybody else is, you know, how are you going up there? How are you going out stating that you should be a high value man? Not messing around with and not be a simp, basically. Proclaiming not to be a simp. Oh, this is downtown. You're proclaiming not to be a simp, but you're doing simp activities. And that's where I agree with a lot of people that are upset when academics brought it up. Now, for me, I'm not upset about it. I take advice from people. And I use what fits for me, right? So, and it's his money, and he can do whatever he wants with it. If he wants to simp, he can go out and be a simp. If he wants to buy girls and trick off girls and do all that stuff, then hey, he can do that. My only thing was, like everybody else's problem with it was that, you know, he's telling people not to do that. Don't be a simp. Or he's making fun of people for being simps. And calling people out. So I think that is a huge detractor from your statements. Because this is what you're trying to teach people. You know, you're trying to teach people. You're having people pay for your course. And this is what you're explaining. And then you're sitting up there, you know, literally just... Oh, there's one. You're literally just sitting up there with a gold digger right next to you, and you're buying all this stuff for her, taking her out on dates and stuff. And yeah, it might be true that, you know, you pay for her dog, for dog sitting and whatever. Yeah, I don't think anybody's questioning that, but it's just really suspicious, you know, and for him to be so oblivious to it is really weird to say, oh, this woman wants me for me. But when you hear the conversation and you start to think to yourself, wait. So the first day she didn't come out on the yacht, or she didn't want to hang out with you to go out. But then when you said you wanted to go on the yacht, if you want to come hang out with me on the yacht, she hopped up and was like, let's do it. That right there, in itself, should have been a red flag. And, you know, he should have known right then and there that he would be criticized for dating this chick. Like, once again, I don't care. That's that man's money. That's that man's business. He can date and smash pass and do all that other stuff. That's on him. That's his money. That's his body. I don't care about that. But I do agree with people about the dang, these flamingos are really hard to find in these cities without pausing. But I do agree that you can't preach something and then go against what you're preaching. Now, he is different from Myron. Myron is a lot different. Myron is Myron's a whole different animal.
Myron is Jesus Christ.
Donald Trump crashed into a truck. Yes, Myron is a whole different animal, and I believe Myron is true to his word. You know, I believe Myron is true to his word. He's not going to be... there's one right there. He's not going to be, out here tricking, as far as we know of. You know, but I think Myron's smart enough to not put himself in that situation where he's going to, you know, make himself look like a walking contradiction, right? When it comes to that, this is the West Side. This is not even downtown Park. So I can really see that. And so this is how this whole thing starts. You know, I mean, everybody is going in on him, especially Walter,
bruh.
Mr. Weeks. And they're really giving him all they got, everybody. I was even gonna post a video, but I decided not to, because at the time I just was in Cancun. I was enjoying the time with my now ex-girlfriend. So I think this is under the bridge. I'm stupid.
You stupid.
And I wasn't really concerned with the topic, but I felt like right now is a good time. Since we're just here chatting and talking. So I didn't think much of it. And then Abba and Preach, I watch them religiously too when they do make videos, and I haven't seen one in a while. They came out. Well, it wasn't Abba and Preach, but I forgot who it was first. But it wasn't Abba and Preach, but creators are reaching out to Abba and Preach, saying that, Fresh and Fit was, you know, hitting them with copyright strikes. Alright, I think I need to go somewhere else, because it's reminded me not popping up. But copyright strikes, they, not only did they hit, like, random, you know, like, I don't think they hit Silver Top. I know for sure they hit Abba and Preach. Man, this is a while back. They hit Abba and Preach for sure. The lead attorney. They didn't even hit him. One of their most avid haters. I can't think of his name right now. And that's the one thing about me. I am very bad with remembering people's names and situations. But he's like one of their most avid haters, and he got his Instagram hit. Or he thinks that they hit his Instagram. Which is not neither here or there. But they went after a lot of people. And my first video was about Fresh and Fit. But it wasn't like talking down about them or criticizing them. It was more just about what he said about Beyonce and Jay-Z's relationship. You can go watch it if you follow me. If you subscribe to me, you can definitely find it. So they're basically got 30, I think altogether they probably sent out over 1,000 copyright strikes. I'll put it up on the screen so that you guys can see it. And I'll put up all the content creators that they hit. And I'll link all of their videos that criticize Pressure Fit. I'll link all their videos in the description below. And put them explaining it. And you guys probably seen it, you know, already. So they hit all these people, and they hit them like really, really bad. Where people were, I think a couple of subscribers could have lost. Not subscribers, sorry. A couple of channels could have been removed, and I think, you know, it was really a pathetic move, bro. Like, I really think it was really bad, and it wasn't. It didn't make a good impression on me. I don't think anybody should be proud of something like that, especially taking food out of somebody's mouth. You know, especially if this is all they're doing, right? This is their only career, basically. So I wasn't cool with that. You know, I understand where they're coming from, and there could have been different ways of it being handled. They could have called them and talked to them and even invited them on the show too. And I think that would have been a great idea, just to invite them on the show and say, hey, I understand that you disagree with some of the things we said. How about you come on the show and debate us? Right? And I would have been totally, like, hey, that's responsible. That's RP right there. But what they did, if you believe in it, it is BP. You know, that is some blue pill beta type energy. The whole thing with what happened with Abba preached the first time with them yelling and screaming and talking about his wife, that's BP. You know, that's beta stuff. That's what females do. You know, when a female's losing an argument, what do? They talk about you, how you are and your personality, you know, ad hominis attacks. So that's how I felt about this move. It's like you're trying to silence people. You say you're, you know, I believe with Donald Trump and I don't believe in censorship, which has nothing to do with Donald Trump, but censorship, you know, is a leftist thing, you know. They always try to shut you up. So, you know, you wouldn't suspect that from somebody that, you know, believes in non-censorship, you would think. So, I'm about to jump off. So that was really weird to me. And it was just really disappointing to see that, because you, not that, like I said, not like that, like I follow these dudes religiously, like, oh, I do everything they say. But you would expect better from somebody that is in the RP space. I'm not saying they're alpha males. Nobody, you can be red pill and not be an alpha male, right? So, it's just an ugly scene for them. It didn't make them look any better. It made them look cowardly and weak. You know, and that's what, I just don't see that. But you'd be surprised what you will see, you know. And, that's a tough hit. So, it was tough. And so, you know, and I didn't understand it either, because for another reason, because you want these people to talk about you, right? They have a big fan base. These people are talking about you, millions of them. All these people are talking about you, and they have millions of fans. So I don't understand why you, wouldn't want them to talk about you. Even in a negative light, it's going to bring people to your page, to your channel, because people are going to want to see for themselves, and they're going to want to see how ridiculous you are. So I think that's something that would have benefited them. I just don't understand why, I don't understand why they would go that route. Dude, it is literally no flamingos around here. And when you're doing if you get a whole bunch of them in a row, you can't look at them on the map. They won't show up on the map. They're literally like hidden. So let's move off of that. So that dies down, right? They go on Temple. I watch him too. I'm subscribed to him. Most of the people that I'm gonna talk about in here, I'm subscribed. They go on Timcast. Somebody ask him. Ask Timcast. I'm getting out of downtown, bro. I was looking at the map too. And somebody had asked him about the situation. And the lead attorney had already exposed them, and their lawyer. And I don't have a rep or anything like that, so things that I wouldn't have been able to do. That I would have been able to do if that would have happened to me. Right, so. But what I understand is that if you file a false, I forgot what it's called, CDA, I believe it is, but you file a false copyright claim, you have a certain amount of time before you redact it, and that's the only way it can happen. There's no other way. There's no other way that you can get that taken back, right? You have to redact those claims, those copyright claims. You have to redact them to keep your channel. And even one of their best. Oh my goodness, this guy. I'm not subscribed to him. I can't even think of his name. But he's even proved that point to where you have to redact those claims. There's no other way from it. So when they went on Timcast, and I'll put that in the description as well, so you guys can see that. Man, these some mangoes are not popping up, and I am having trouble getting out of this city. So they go in there and they ask them, why these idiots, they call them idiots, an idiotic move, copyright strike a whole bunch of content creators. And dude, I am literally stuck in Miami somewhere. And they said, they gave their reason of why they did it. So they made their reason why they did it. We all understand their reason. I understand their reason, even though it's not a valid reason. I do understand why. It's frustrating, I'm pretty sure. But it's something that you can't do. And so basically, Temple, tells him that, you can't do that. That's not how it works. And you can see Myron was very disappointed because, they thought that they were going to get away with that. Like, that was going to be the calm to all their problems. But no, that's not how these things work. So Myron goes, and this is the part where he knows, but he's trying to save face. And this is one thing I don't really care for them. Don't try to save face. This is how you rectify the situation, is when you just be honest and say, hey, I fucked up. Just be honest. Hey, I fucked up. There were some things. Let me go down this path right here. There were some things that we did, and that shit wasn't cool, and we messed up. We thought we could do it, and we fucked up, and we apologized. It's that simple, bro. It's literally that simple. I know you don't want to be made fun of. You don't want to get it wrong. But you're already there now, and you're already, you know, you're already wrong. So people are going to talk about you anyways. You might as well do the noble thing, and you know, try to get some of the. Damn, I'm crashing everything. Try to do the noble thing and try to. Oh, there's a flamingo right there. Try to do the noble thing and get people to understand that, hey, we made a mistake. You know, hopefully us apologizing, we can learn from our mistakes and miss our mistakes. But no, this dude said, that's a talk for, he said something like, that's a talk for another time or for another day or something, or it's a long story. No, nigga, excuse my language, it's not a long story. It's not a talk for another, this dude crashed. Why are they all crashing? No, bro, you took the copyright strikes back. That's just plain and simple, bro. Like, there's no other way to overcome it. Just say, hey, he could have said, you know what? We were able to strike down some people. But, you know, we didn't understand the law properly. Even that, he could have said we didn't understand, because they're new on YouTube. They only been doing this for a year, year and a half. So they could have came out, even used that excuse like, hey, we're really new here on YouTube. We didn't really understand how the copyright system works, because a lot of people don't understand how the copyright system works. So they that could have got them out of the hole right there. You know, just say, hey, we made a mistake. We thought this is what we could do. And we accidentally, keyword, accidentally abused the copyright system. You know, because a lot of people don't know. A lot of people don't pay attention to it. They just assume. They just assume, hey, this guy's copywriting. Let me put a claim on him. So that would have been, you know, something really simple, something really easy. You know, it would have got them out the hole, but they just keep putting themselves back into the hole. They just keep doing it to themselves, and that is the worst. I don't like trust. Excuse me, there's another flamingo. It's like, bro, just stop. It's okay. It's okay. Nothing's gonna happen to your channel. You admit you're wrong, people will criticize you for a day or two, and then you move on. People watch it. Yeah, okay, cool. But don't be up there just lying and lying and sweeping stuff under the rug. Like, so that was another disappointing thing for me. I was like, damn, they just have to be better. Well, it doesn't get any better as time goes on. Dude, we are really trying to find these flamingos, and these things are, they only appear when you, like, if you drive by them. Like I said, you can't pause it and look on the map. And, so, you know, what was I gonna say? Sorry. You would think that it's gonna get better. They're gonna let the, you know, they're gonna go back and do the show. Everybody's gonna go back on YouTube and do their thing, and we're gonna be at peace. And we ain't gotta make content on Fresh and Fit and make a ton of money off of it. Right? But no, I guess that's not the end of it. Because, is that a flamingo? No, it's a no, they gotta. And this one is really tough for me. This one will be probably the last one we talk about. As I'm really trying to find these flamingos as we're driving around. And this is a big one. And I have to agree with Fresh and Fit on a lot of this. And I also have to agree with the public. Now, I'm no liberal. I ain't into all that. I ain't no leftist. I ain't no victim. I don't be doing all that. I work hard to get to where I'm at in life, and I'm gonna keep working hard. You know, and I will appreciate and be humble in my success. You know what I mean? But I'm not gonna play the victim role. I am an African American man. That is not. I don't get down like that. That's not my thing. There's a lot of things that you can say that happened 100 years back or whatever, but I'm not gonna make that a reason why I can't be successful, right? That's not gonna be my reasoning to why I didn't make it in life. I went to school, I got a bachelor's degree,
surprise, yeah, motherfucker.
Oh my goodness.
Jesus Christ.
I'm glad I've got that. I'm glad that was recorded. I've done it. I worked hard. I'm working a good job. I'm having fun talking to people on YouTube and playing video games, you know, so I'm blessed with that. You know, so I'll never play that victim mentality. But what I will say is, I do have to agree with Fresh and Fit on this topic. But I have to, there is some things that I will look at that are a little sus, right? When it comes to black women, so there's a flamingo. This is a really tough topic, and this is why I want to do this, because I want to create... Woo! Because I want to create these conversations so we can all talk about them in the comment section. Now, first and foremost, not every black woman is ratchet or ghetto. We know that. But what I will say is, the ones that are that do come out and they portray themselves on TV and the way they act, it gives off a stigma that black women are ratchet and ghetto, and it's plays throughout history. And am I going back across this bridge? You know, and it's through a stigma, through history, right? That people see this. And like I said, once again, that doesn't mean every black woman is. But I've lived in the hood. I've been in South Central. I've lived everywhere. I lived in a lot of places. You know, but I have never mostly seen anything different than a ghetto black chick. You know what I mean? I've ran into some I've seen some well-mannered, you know, beautiful black women, dark skin. I'm not a colorist. I don't believe in all that color shaming or whatever it is. I don't really care about that. You black. Light skin or not, you a black person. You fit that criteria, you black. So I can kind of understand from a point with the women that they deal with, and just recently on the podcast, and I'll put the clip in so you guys can see that.
Jesus Christ.
So I'll put the clip in so that you guys can see that. But you know, that's the attitude that you usually get, and that's not what you want to deal with. And there's, oh gosh, don't get me started. There's ghetto white women. There's ghetto Asian women. There's ratchet women of all kinds. But specifically, just for this conversation, we are just talking about black women. You know, and how they're portrayed in the media, and how they portray themselves. And we gotta remember, you know, and how they portray themselves in the media. Like, I'm saying, like in movies, and, you know, they're on TV, they're ratchet on TV, they're acting out, they're wild. And, you know, when a man sees that, you know, it kind of detracts, you know, away from those types of women. And it's true. And I'll put this up I'll put this up on the screen too. It's true. On most dating websites, well, this is through OkCupid. I'm not going to say most, but on OkCupid, I think it's OkCupid. I got to look at the study again, but I know it's a dating website. Black women are the least women that are targeted. And it's very unfortunate. It's very unfortunate. It's really sad, but I mean, that's the stigma that comes with black women. That ghetto ratchet, stigma. It's unfortunate, but it's portrayed. Oh, I didn't definitely like that. I like my baby. But it's portrayed in even rap music. They're going out being ghetto and doing ghetto stuff, and I know it's just music, it's entertainment, but that's a perception that you give people, right? I'm pretty sure they're wonderful women, smart, educated, but it's what you do and what people see. What you do behind the scenes is not going to be an impression on people until they see it. But what you do in the forefront, everybody's going to see it. And that's what I believe at some point that freshman fit is saying. Now, I don't agree with freshman fit about the Shaquanda, and calling them their names. But that is not technically wrong either, because there are women called Shaquanda. You know, that's why when I have a kid, when I have a kid, I don't want them to have a name like that. Black kid, white kid, whatever, whoever I end up marrying and have a kid with, I would want them to have a name like that. That's my preference. I don't really care for that type of name. You know what I mean? I don't care for that stuff. I want my kid to have a simple name. Everybody can recognize him. They can answer him. When he applies for a job, they have to look at his name crazy. And I know that sounds sad, but that's what people do. They really look at your application and say, wow. It is sad, but that's the life that we live. Oh, there's a flamingo right there. Here for a second. Applied to Robert. Yeah, so it's tough. It is tough. And I'm not going to sit here and say black women are oppressed. No, they're not. No, I'm not going to say that crap. Black women are not oppressed. I don't agree with that at all. Black women are most educated, or they're highly, highly at the top of all education graduation classes. That will be, I think in 2016, black women graduated the most from college. Right? They're the most, I think amongst females, if I don't want to be wrong, but they're the highest of job earners. So I don't agree with that oppressed stuff, right? So, and where I'm getting to is basically, so now they're on Fresh and Fit. I don't even know her name, to be honest with you. I don't really listen. I guess she was King Von's girlfriend. Rest in peace to him. That's very tragic. I can't stand black on black killings. I'm not saying that any killing is acceptable, but we can't. We live in a world where we complain about, you know, white people killing other people killing us, but we're not. We're over here killing each other at a high rate, especially our rich, successful people that we are killing, where we need to grow financially as a community. But that's a little bit for here and there. I don't even know who she is, to be honest with you, and I really don't care, because I don't listen to her music. I don't know her personally. She doesn't know me personally. She probably doesn't never even want to see this. So at the end of the day, as much as she cares, it's as much as I care. And I'm assuming we both don't care because we don't know. You know, she did come. I have to agree. She did come late to the pod. The girl was being interruptive. Everybody. There's nobody that even that any detractors of Fresh and Fit. Nobody says that. They're wrong about this. They all agree that, yeah, she came late to the pod, and, you know, she was being disruptive with the other girl. Nobody agrees with that. Now, another thing is, she was saying that he was mean. I don't think Myron should have went off on her like that. But I do agree he should have told her, he should have explained to her that, hey, look, I've been doing this show. We've been doing the show for the past 2 hours. This girl's been interrupting. I've been telling her six or seven times. Hey, you know, stop. Please stop interrupting. I can't say it again. And I think Myra should have took the approach to say, you know what? I gave you chance after chance. You got to go. And that's not even... I don't think that would even have been a mean thing. I think that would have been an easier way to solve the situation is just to let her know, hey, I gave you chance after chance. We asked you nicely. We asked you multiple times to, you know, stop side talking, basically. You know, and I can agree with that. You know, I can agree with that. Like, hey, you know, you've been kind of really just talking while other people are talking. You're talking over them, and people can't.
You must be some kind of a dumbass.
You know, and people can't. I can't get this flamingo. That's what I can't do. And people can't hear you talk. They can't hear the other person talking. Oh, this is right here. We're gonna be doing this one too. Oh, this is the big booty viper, but there's another one in here that we're gonna be doing. People can't hear over you talking. They're trying to hear what this woman is saying, and you're interrupting. Simple. That's even a better excuse to kick her out. You don't have to kick her out because she's being rude or whatever. You can kick her out now because you asked her multiple. Oh, there it is. No, that's not a flamingo. You can kick her out now because you asked her multiple times, hey, can you please stop with the sidebar? And that probably would have been more acceptable. Now, damn, I still can't think of her name. I still don't know her name. With this, dude, I cannot get this flamingo. I don't even know where it's at. It's right here, but maybe I passed it. She came in late. Oh, I think it's right here. Yeah. She came in late. And, you know, she said what she said. I would have just shrugged her off and just would have been like, you know, I would have just shrugged her off and been like, hey, you know, she's been side talking. And then that's the end of it. And then I don't think the other girl, I don't know her name, but the rapper or whoever she is, I don't think that she should have kept on talking about, oh, I say what I want to say and do what I want to do. You know, I have to agree, like, no. I mean, you're a guest on the show. You can. I agree that you can. You have the right to. But you're on my show. Right? I don't have to allow you to be here. Right? So those are things that I can agree with. Right? She was being ghetto. You know, acting immature. You know, not acting like an adult. Talking ghetto. Talking about I can do whatever. You know, that masculine stuff. That we don't want to, and this is where it comes from, that we see in black women that are making them the least dated women on websites or just in general, you know, and that's not to end it, and I have to say it again, these are not all black women, there are smart and beautiful black women, but these are just the women that are being portrayed or that we see and how they act in public. Because remember, like I said, what you do in the background, nobody sees. What you do in the foreground, the whole world is watching. So if you're acting like that, what do you think people are going to see? How do you think people are going to act? Now, does that give them an excuse to judge all black women? No, I'm not saying that. But that's the perception that a lot of black women give off, right? That's tough, you know? That's tough, it really is. You know, we have stereotypes for a reason. There are literal reasons why we have stereotypes. You know, and nobody can say that, oh, that's racist or that's stereotypical. No, they're there for a reason. Yeah, everybody likes watermelon. Everybody likes fried chicken. But I guarantee you told a black person they want fried chicken, they're gonna be like, yeah, hell yeah, I want some fried chicken, you know, because that's what we're known for. You know, that's a stereotype for a reason. Stereotypes have some truth in them. And there's nothing wrong with that. I love fried chicken, I love watermelon. Shit. If you think that telling me that it's wrong for me, it's a stereotype, it's wrong, you done lost your mind. I love me some fried chicken. I love me some watermelon chewy. See? So, we have to remember those stereotypes are being brought out because of what people see, and then they assume that. And that's not for every woman. If I don't know the woman and she's just walking down the street, I'm not going to assume that she's a ghetto ratchet woman. Of course not. But, you know, unfortunately, there's that high percentage chance that she might be. Right? And that goes for white. I mean, it just really depends. If I see a white woman, that's really tough. Because the stereotypical views that I get of white women are the white women I would have been around are very civil. Peaceful. And I've been around very peaceful black girls, but the majority of black girls that I have been around have been very masculine, very ghetto, and it's really sad. And like I said, I've met some ghetto ass white girls. Don't get the game twisted, player. But let's get back to the freshman fit and last thing that. I really don't think I'm gonna find all these flamingos in this episode. To be rough for life, he wants to play. He's just blowing me up everywhere. But you guys come first, so I have to make sure I do complete this episode. I am in the bushes. My car is taking a pounding down there, Paul's. You know, that's where that stigma comes from, and they're in Miami. And this is one thing I don't like either. Freshman Fit put a lot of Miami things out as if it's happening everywhere. It happens in certain places, yes, but we can't live. Not everywhere, where everybody lives is like Miami or like Los Angeles or like San Diego or, you know, like the nightlife in Arizona. Maybe Tempe and stuff like that, right? We got people that live in South Dakota, North Dakota, you know, in Vermont, Utah, you know, Delaware. Like, they just don't have the same lifestyle. So that's another thing I kind of disagree with. Not every woman, and those, especially in that situation, is going to be the same. I do agree that women look for high value men, and they're. Most men are virgins. I'll put that up there too. On the screen, most men are virgins. That is true. Oh my goodness. So, that is true. But let's get back to this. So, they went on this show talking about they don't want no Shaniquas, and this is an old clip. So, the lady, she ends up leaving, which I mean, it's not a good. I'm assuming it doesn't bother Fresh Fit because I didn't know who she was. Shit, Fresh didn't even know who she was. And I don't really listen to New Age rap like that. So I'm not even gonna sit here cap. I didn't know who she was, so I didn't give a fuck. So I was like, oh, that's one less person we have to deal with. Let's get the show on because I wanna hear what the women gotta say because. Me, truly, as a psychology major, I got my bachelor's in psychology. I want to see where their minds are at. I want to hear from them. Myron always has the same shtick. You know, this percentage and this percentage. We know, bro. I've done the study. I've done the work. I know. But I want to see what these women think and how they're different. And I definitely have a shout out. What's her name? Nina. It was a girl in green that was there. Very calm, very different. Obviously, she's from a different country. And that just tells you the difference between women here and other countries. It doesn't make anybody... And I'm not talking about just women in general. I'm just talking about those type of women that come on the show. Nina, SJ, or Slow Jams... So Icy, which I think So Icy is, she is gorgeous. She is gorgeous. I think she's a very attractive woman. And her personality is down to her. She's really cool. But yeah, Nina, SJ, So Icy. Those three for sure, those are, and I'm not going to be on their Instagram. You guys can go on my Instagram. You know I ain't following no models, nothing. I don't really be doing that around. If you ain't following me, I ain't following you. I don't know, right? Dude, I'm back here and I cannot find any flamingos. But we're just here. We're gonna be on still. We're still gonna be on. It's just get this thought out. So, dude, I cannot find any flamingos. I've just been driving around. So you know, I guess she goes out and says she's trying to protect the girl. But what is funny though, the girl is telling her to stop. You know, she's not telling Fresh and Fit to stop. She's telling the rapper chick to stop. Like, hey, no, she's being accountable. That's what I like to see. Accountable people just in general, not just women, men. Especially men. Men need to be accountable for everything they do. Because we are what they hate right now. Right? You gotta be accountable for everything you do. And you need to go out and be responsible and become a leader. Stop crying on other people's shoulders for your failures. Take accountability. Ooh. I crashed into that car. Take accountability and become a better man. But that's neither here nor there. So she was telling her, like, hey, you know, I've been messing up. I've been doing things to disrupt the show. So I applaud her for that because she was like, no, I understand. Like, I've been doing stuff. I'm trying to tell her to calm down. Because I'm in the wrong, so I applaud that. But the rapper chick, she wasn't letting it go. Then, I guess the shade room picked it up because she's quote unquote famous, I guess. And so they picked it up, and they, I guess, like told, like said that Fresh and Fit was being colorist, which I don't believe in that shit either. Like, people just have preferences. No, I guess you could say people are colorist. But this is what I always say. The people that are the ones that are fighting for the cause are the ones that... The ones that are fighting for the cause are the ones that have... The ones that are fighting for the cause are the ones that have something to hide. They're the reason why the... Oh, there's the flamingo right there. They're the reason why the cause is. But they're trying to... Oh, there's two flamingos. Let's go. They're hiding behind the cause because they're the reason for it, if that makes any sense. Like, they're hiding behind the cause because they have those same, they have the same things in them that they're fighting with the cause or something. I can't really explain how I'm trying to say it. But it's basically like, it's a person that, it's a person that basically doesn't, that might be a, that might not like dark-skinned women, but only like light-skinned women. But they'll join the cause because obviously it's going to get them some ups here and there. Somebody crash again, not paying attention. It's going to get them some ups and downs here, but then it's a cover-up for what they really are, right? They're just using it to cover up what they really are so they can get away with their scheme, right? That's most of this SJW stuff right now. All this stuff, that's all it is. It's literally just people that are hiding their own things, right? We saw that with Ellen, you know, with the whole bully thing, and, you know, come to find out she's the biggest bully, and, you know, she was just using the leftist narrative to cover up her actions. That's what people do, so that they are out of the spotlight. So the Shade Room posts this thing, and I guess they go back, and she says that she was trying to protect her, but we've seen, everybody can clearly see as day that the girl doesn't even want her protected. So, Shaymon puts it, spins it, then they take a clip from a year ago. Now, this is where I disagree with Fresh and Fit. Hey, it's fine to have preferences, bro. I love Asian and Hispanic. Love them. Love them. I don't care what nobody says. I will take one anytime, anywhere. I love Asian and Hispanics. Does that mean that I would not date a black girl? No. But I love me some Asian and Hispanics. That's what I do. I do love me some Asian and Hispanics. That's something that I like. That's something I like. That's something I would go after. Right? That doesn't mean, like I said in the beginning, that doesn't mean that a black woman. Oh, this better not be a woman. That I might not marry a black woman. I don't want the future of us, but I do love me some Asian and Hispanic. Yum meat. Now, especially the thick ones. Thick ones is nice. Now, you know, so everybody twisted that. And, oh, this is the mall. So everyone twisted that and they started saying that they don't like black women. Because they were saying the Shanique was, and they kicked the black woman out, and they did all that. Now, this is where I disagree with Fresh and Fit. I don't think people are mad because you're of your preference. Of their preference, sorry. I think people are mad is how you express yourself. Of your preferences. I think that's the problem, is how you express yourself by turning it into an instant joke. Right, for me, like I said, I don't care. It don't bother me at all. Like, that's their life. They date whoever. And I hate people. I don't hate people for that. I don't really have hate in my heart. I think that's the worst thing to do is have hate. But I just like people that try to control. Like, bro, you're not going to tell me what to put my dick in. Excuse my language. Where's that board was in there?
Perfect.
Right, that's just not... That's just not gonna happen, man. Like this, I don't care how mad you get or what you think of me. I'm going to date who I want to date and do what I want to do. Right? That's the worst. It's like these people like come out of nowhere and like, oh, you have to do it. No, nigga, I ain't got to do a damn thing. It's my life. That's the only thing that bothers me. It's like when you tell me what I have to do with my life, you should be. Come on, bro. Really, nigga? Really? They put the flamingo up there? That's what... Can I even get up there? That's what people should be concerned with, their own life. But I do get what the people are trying to say when you're making these jokes. It's like an insensitive time, I guess. Right? It's just an insensitive time to say, we don't dabble in the dark, and we don't do this, and we don't do that. I guess that's an instance thing to say in that instance, right? Especially, you know, there's so many sensitive people out here. That's what you should be aware of, the sensitive people, not the normies that are not freaking out about that stuff. You know, not the 99 or 98% of people that don't freak out about that stuff, but you need to watch out for the 0.22% of people that freak out about that stuff. You know, and kind of just, you know, just be like, hey, that's not our preference, right? We don't have nothing, and you can obviously tell they don't have nothing against black women. Any regular person can see that they don't have nothing against black women. You can go on their blogs, you can go on their TV shows, you can go on their Instagram. There's black women all over the place. I think he was married to a black woman. I think that's one thing he said, right? So the whole that they don't like black women thing, that's stupid. That's a dumb narrative, right? Even I, out of all their stupidities, that's one thing that I can't sit up here and say that they don't like black women. That doesn't make any sense. I am not getting that flamingo. That doesn't make sense at all, because if you really... And it doesn't, and this is another thing that some idiot was saying. He called in the other night, he was saying something stupid. Oh, well, you know, you don't like black women and they're on your show because you use them. No, the woman chose to be there. She didn't have to go, they didn't force her to go there. It's so true that if you, discrimination is a very strong word. Discrimination means you hate, just like misogyny, you hate that race or sex. I can attest to you right now. I think with all my money in my bank, my savings, and all my cryptos, everything, there's no black people in the KKK. I can guarantee it. You know why? Because they hate black people. There's a difference. So if you tell me, as a random person walking down the street, I never seen Fresh and Fit in my life, and you, and they have the knowledge and patience and understanding that I have, if you told me that they hated black women, I would look at you stupid. Because there's black women on the show. They hang out with black women. It's just, it don't make no sense. That don't make no sense. Right? I don't hang out with racist people. You know why? Because I don't like racist people. I guarantee you won't find a racist hanging out with me ever. And that could be discrimination, I guess you could say, to a certain extent. But I don't like racist people. So I don't hang out with racist people. They are not involved in my life. So we have to put that same logic when it comes to them not liking black women. If they didn't like black women, why would they involve them in their life? Dude, I'm way over here back by the track. I went all around the city and I barely found, I think, like 17 flamingos. You know, so that's just the thing that I don't understand when people say stupid stuff like that. So this caller came in, he called in on the show after this, and he was talking about, well, you're a colorist because, oh, there's a flamingo right here. Get that. You're a colorist because, well, basically it was like, because you don't like dark-skinned women. That was like the first thing he said.
You must be some kind of a dumbass.
I really wanted that flamingo. He said, because you don't like dark-skinned women. So they brought up the word. He was trying to make them. This is one thing I hate about people too, is when they criticize you and call you out of your name, then they tell you to define what they're claiming. No, bro, if you claim something, you need to know what your claims are. Oh, okay, I got Palm City. No, bro, you came to me with a claim. How are you going to tell me to define something that you're claiming me of? Like, that doesn't make any sense, bro. If you create a claim, you need to be able to substantiate that claim. You need to tell me what the definition of and why you think I'm doing this. Or why do you believe? Because what you think doesn't matter. Why do you believe I'm doing this? Like, what gives you the reasoning to say that I'm a colorist or whatever? So this dude, so he basically read it out and he said it's the hate of dark-skinned people. So, like, I go back to, like, hate is, if you hate somebody, you're not hanging around people you hate. Let's go back to the KKK reference. There's no black people in the KKK because they hate black people. So we have to think about the things we say. So the guy says, well, you hate black women. He says, Myron says, well, if we, and even So Icy and all those people are on the show, they're like, how do they hate black women when they're always around black women? You know what the guy says? Well, because it benefits you. Now you're moving the goalposts, bro. Now you, oh, well, benefit you. It's not benefiting them. It does benefit them because they get to talk to 500,000 people. If you know, every show there's 10,000 people, up to 10, anywhere from 6,000 to 10,000 people watching the late night show. There's people donating just to get a holler at these girls. Do you think in your right mind that this is not benefiting them? Then you're stupid. You're an idiot. Stop talking. Hang up the phone. They are promoting these women. These women are promoting themselves. They're promoting their OnlyFans. They're promoting where they work. they have a platform to talk to thousands of people. Is that a hate for a black woman to allow her, to come on a platform and promote herself? Is that hate? I don't think so. Oh, crash. I don't think so. I don't think that's hate. Do you think that's hate? I don't think that's hate. I think that's giving black people a platform. Oh, I thought that's what we were fighting for. Black people getting a platform. And see, this is why these criticisms don't make no sense. So then after that, when they said, yeah, we do, you know what the guy says? Well, you're not dating them. Or have, like, bro, now you're just adding. I don't think I'm going to find any more flamingos, so we're going to end it pretty soon. But I don't think you're, bro, you're just moving the goalposts. You're just finding an excuse after excuse after excuse after excuse after excuse to try to fit your narrative. Like, bro, that's not what it is. You're just saying stuff. Like, the definition is what you stated. That's the only fact that matters, is what the definition states. If the definition states that discrimination against dark-skinned people, if you can't prove that they have discriminated against dark-skinned people, then your claims mean nothing. Stop moving the goalposts. Stop saying you won't date them. Stop saying you don't hang out with them. Saying you don't say that you ain't creating a platform with them. Just state that, hey, I'm wrong. You're not whatever that shit is, a colorist or colorist, whatever that is. That shit's stupid, bro. I don't talk to people that do shit like that. If you have to make an excuse for every little thing and if you keep moving the goalposts and to try to prove your point, I walk away from you. I don't deal with you. I just don't have time for it. But, you know, it's really sad. And so, I don't think I'm going to find any more flamingos, guys. Because I don't see any and I can't pause it to find any. Oh, I almost cracked his hand, too. So, with all that being said, man, it's tough, bro. It's tough. But they made themselves look bad. Fresh and Fit made themselves look bad, bro. They should. I think you gotta just be careful in these times and days. Never hold your tongue. I wouldn't say hold your tongue, but I think you could have made a different type of joke. There could have been a different type of joke. A reason is why you don't date black girls, right? Yes, you could say, hey, some of them, not all of them, just say some of them, are ghetto and ratchet, and I don't date those type of people. I don't date ghetto people or ratchet people, right? You don't have to say, you can say, my preference is not black women. And then after that, you can say, I prefer white women. I just don't date ghetto people. You know, I don't date ratchets, like, you know, very simple ways you just could have came off of that. So everybody was roasting him for that. And I feel like that's a two-way sword you can go all day. Because like he said, it's true. Nobody bats an eye if a black woman comes out and says, I only date white guys. Or, you know, they say black men are bad. Like, we all got to be honest here. Nobody cares. Right? So... Oops. I am not finding no flamingos. I am driving around here like a madman. So the last thing I wanted to talk about, and I'm gonna grade this whole situation for them, is just, man, the whole name with the Fragrant Podcast. You have to remember, the Fragrant Podcast, those dudes are married, bro. They have no idea what's going on, bro. They don't live in the world like most single men do. They only know what they know. They've been married for all their lives. And I can't think of his name, and I'm not going to butcher his name, but the comedian, I think he's funny as hell. He talks about air. And this is my kind of thing. I'm glad he was kind of quiet, because he will be a contradiction right away. Because he makes fun and he talks shit about everything. Every single thing. He's hilarious. I love him. No homo. But he's hilarious. He's a really funny comedian. But if you've been married since high school, or after high school, you can't really compare women because you have no knowledge. You've dated one woman all your life. You haven't been out in the world. And I'm not saying that, no, it wouldn't be on the beach. I'm not saying he ain't never cheated on his wife or he ain't been around women, you know. But, you know, if this is your solid answer to your reply to them, that, you know, the outlook is not what you guys say, because I'm married and I have been with the same woman, then you have no knowledge in the game. You are not out there. You are just with your wife. And this is, we're talking about men that are not married, that are single, that have to go out in the world and deal with these women, right? They have to play the dating game and stuff. And I'm one of them. I have to go out here and court women and date them. And, you know, I have to do that. So that, for them to sit up there and be like, oh, that's not the way the world works, bro, you don't know, bro. You just don't know because you're married. You have no knowledge in the game. You don't know how these women act. They're both married, so like their argument is futile because they don't have no knowledge in the game. And he was talking about his friend with the mustard stain. Bro, if your friend's a Chad, bro, he's gonna get girls, bro, regardless if he has a mustard stain or not. But people that are in the house, bro, playing Zelda and shit, little dorks, they ain't getting nothing. Ain't nobody even looking at them. That's why we'll put it up again that most men are virgins. The majority of men are virgins. So their whole stance and logic is just irrelevant because they don't live. They're not in the dating market. They don't live in that world. So they don't know how hard it is or what goes on. Right? So it doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense. I am tired of driving around because these flamingos is just not popping up for your boy. Oh, there was one more thing with the Brittany Renner thing. Everything's taken out of context. You're probably gonna see a clip here that I'm gonna take out of context that I will put up to get to see you or whatever. But, you know, it's tough for a woman like her. I really feel bad, and I don't feel bad at the same time. The reason why I feel bad is because people are gonna come at you, right? And, I mean, that's the life you set up for yourself. It sucks. And then I feel bad because every day you go out and you embarrass yourself even more. And that's why I feel bad, is because you don't know that you're... Maybe she does know. Maybe she's playing everybody. But either you're okay with it or you just don't know that you're just... Oh, there's a jump right here. There's a 33-yard right. I gotta stop doing these jumps because I need to beat these really fast. Oh, I'm in the water. Oh, that was solid ground. Because you don't know. You know, she don't know, so I just feel bad that she's doing it. Maybe she doesn't understand that. It makes her look bad. Everything she does, and I hope she's really changing to go on the right path and start her show. And give a different perspective for herself. That's gonna be awesome. That whole thing was just a whole different thing, you know. That's, it should be good. But yeah, now where I don't feel bad is she did that shit to herself. Nobody could. She did all that shit to herself, writing books and putting herself out there as a hoe and chasing men for money. You know, she did that all by herself. Nobody can take that from her. That is her title. She cannot say that she's a victim. And no, you did that to yourself, and you need to take responsibility and be accountable for your actions, miss. You know, that is completely 100% your fault. So, Myra should have been straight up with her. I'd have been straight up with her. I would have been like, women like you. Oh, there's a flamingo right when we were about to just head on out of here. I would have told her straight out, women like you. Because when you gotta, that's one thing about Myron too that I dislike. He just cowers when, and I don't want to say that he cowers, but he just, like, bruh, if you gonna say something, bruh, say it with your chest every time, even in front of that person, right? Just say it with your chest, bro. Yeah, I said it. Women like you, right? And you know why? Because you put yourself out there. You put yourself out there like that. Nobody else. Oh, there's another for me. Nobody else did this but yourself, right? You went out there. You wrote a book about scamming men and trapping men and stuff like that. So, yeah, women like you. You know, women who follow you that do that type of stuff. There is nothing wrong with calling somebody out on their bullshit. That's life. She put that out there for the world to see. So if you want to say, hey, women like you, then you say women like you, because she had already promoted how she is. You know, she can't take that back. That's not coming back. I don't think I ever been to her. Let me go the other way. She can't take that back. That's not coming back. So that's something she just has to deal with. Right? And I don't feel bad for her, because she did that to herself. And it's the same for a guy. If a guy was out there, he was just scamming women and people were shaming him, I wouldn't care. That's that nigga's fault. He need to be responsible. He need to take accountability. That's your fault, fool. That's what you get. Right? So, is this another flamingo? Yeah, man. So, I think we're going to just... But, you know, I'm going to get fresh and fit, man. Just over these past few months. You know, doing a copyright thing, man. That one is... That's tough, bro. That's really bad. That's a real bad look. The black woman thing is a bad look. Not completely, but I do agree that, you know, just... I don't want people to think that it's okay to be soft and be in your feelings. But it's also that it's also okay to... Oh, another flamingo right here. It is up. It's okay to explain things in a more simpler form, right? Oh, now I am not getting up there. It's okay to explain things and to be serious, right? You don't have to joke all the time. It's okay to be serious and get your point across in a serious tone so that people understand you. I'm trying to get this flamingo. It says there's a road right here, but I don't see it. There's two flamingos right here. Dude, they're not crashing in the water, bro. So I need to get rid of this one. But I won't be able to. I'm going straight into the bottom. Yeah. There's a road right here. Well, how was I going in the water? I don't know. But, yeah, so that one thing is, I think was pretty bad. But all in all, I have to give credit for it. I have to give him like a C. I don't really know. I think there's some things that they could have done better to help their cases, and I fell. Bro, dude, they said, nigga, they just went to this. They can do that one. There was just some things they could have done better. So, oh, it's right here. lunch right here. Yeah, man, it's been a tough year for them. And I hope that they see their flaws, and I hope they see the things they can work on. But we'll probably be having another discussion pretty soon, you know? Because they'll be right back on here, right back on YouTube, saying something or doing something that will get big headlines, and you know we'll be going on from there. So I'm going to try to get this last Flamingo for you guys before I hit it with game Run for Life. Let's get back to the house. So I can let you guys go, but I just want to have that conversation with you guys. Let me know what you guys think about the first episode. I mean, maybe we can stand and work on these together, and we can have great conversation because I think So the next time we have an episode like this, we will be getting the billboards. I'm going to try to finish the, and here's one right here when I'm driving up to go out. You see how the game does here? Oh, but it's under the bridge. Let me just get this one real quick. Alright y'all, so that will end the video. I appreciate y'all coming down and having a sit down talk with me. I hope we all learned something today, and hopefully I can learn something from you guys. But without further ado, let's graduate, Rhodes Scholars.